Good day, everyone. I am Teacher Hannah, and today we'll be talking about distance learning. So what is distance learning? It refers to instruction and learning that are delivered remotely as a whole course or through a large portion of it, since face-to-face and in-person sessions between the learners and educators are limited or impossible. Technology plays a vital role in allowing distance learning to happen synchronously or asynchronously. So what is synchronous learning and asynchronous learning? Due to digital era that we live in, we are overwhelmed by new learning technologies. All these new technologies have one thing in common. They support asynchronous learning. But wait, what is asynchronous learning? And how does it compare to synchronous learning? Let's start with an explanation of the old-fashioned way. Synchronous learning refers to a learning event in which a group of participants is engaged in learning at the same time. For that, they should be in the same physical location as a classroom or the same online environment, such as a web conference, where they can interact with a teacher and other participants. There is real interaction with other people. What are the pros or advantages of synchronous learning? First, interaction between participants. Second, exchange of knowledge and experience between participants. Third, real-time feedback from the teacher. And now, what is asynchronous learning? Asynchronous learning happens when the teacher, the learner, and the other participants are not engaged in the learning process at the same time. There's no real-time interaction with other people. So what are the pros and advantages of asynchronous learning? There are many benefits to asynchronous learning. The most obvious benefit is flexibility, which allows non-traditional students to balance family, work, and school in a way that works for their schedules. This flexibility can also be beneficial to younger students with health issues that limit time in school or with other needs that cannot be met in a traditional classroom, but can be addressed through an online program. The other benefits of asynchronous learning aren't obvious, but are nonetheless important. First, individual pacing. By definition, asynchronous learning allows students to design their own learning schedules. This allows learners to spend more time on challenging areas and work towards mastery, instead of deadlines imposed from above. Individual pacing helps address different learning styles as well as different learning disabilities. Second, asynchronous collaboration. Using discussion boards and interactive document editing can help students engage more deeply with the material as they communicate with each other. Asynchronous collaboration allows students to reach out for help when they need it and to work with the material as long as needed before sharing their thoughts with others, leading to a richer and more personalized learning overall. And lastly, portfolio learning. Because students don't necessarily sit for a single exam, assessment of asynchronous learning is often comprised of portfolio of material demonstrating mastery. At its best, an online learning portfolio can contain a rich collection of video, presentation, and other multimedia projects that show what they have learned in a much deeper way than a standardized test. And these projects can follow students throughout their academic careers and into the real world. Upon learning about synchronous and asynchronous learning, here are the three things to consider before transitioning to asynchronous learning. Asynchronous learning has many benefits, but it's not without its challenges. Before adding asynchronous element to your teaching, ponder these questions to make sure your course functions well. First, how and when will you provide feedback? Regular feedback is essential to clear up misunderstandings and offer encouragement, but not seeing your students in real time can slow the process. Second, how will you make lessons accessible and entertaining? You won't be able to shift gears when you see students are bored, so plan ways to make your lesson engaging and exciting. This requires high-quality video and presentation, which are time-consuming to produce but are very efficient. Third, how will you promote higher-order thinking? It's not always easy to plan online activities that go beyond multiple-choice quizzes and flashcards, but organizing in-depth projects and practice is very crucial. And lastly, how will you divide units into smaller lessons? Bite-sized modules are key to providing flexibility for asynchronous learners. To sum it up, synchronous learning requires attendance at a scheduled meeting or lecture, while asynchronous learning allows students to access materials, ask questions, and practice their skills at any time that works for them. In this coming academic school year, as an educator, which one do you prefer, synchronous, asynchronous, or a combination of both? It's for you to decide which one will benefit your students more. Subscribe, like, and hit the notification bell to be up to date. And I'll see you in the next video. Ciao!